Well, I'm happy to report a nice sound. Believe it or not, pops and bangs. This is the standard now. It's pretty crazy, actually. Right on the money. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got the all new 3 Series by BMW, the G20. I know we're a little late to the party because, it just wasn't available sooner for us. So here it is. It's the new 3 Series and it is really nice to finally drive it. Today I'm going to walk around it, show you the features on this car, show you the spec we've got it in. We'll take it for a drive along this road and then we'll take it to the Autobahn for a little Autobahn blast to see what it's like. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload a new video. And follow us on Instagram at Autotop.nl. Alright, so the new 3 Series. Well, it is a lot bigger than before, actually. It is wider. It's 7 centimeters longer than before. It has sort of a new own face, I would say, with that headlight shape, with the new big wide grille. We have a Mediterranean blue car today with a sport line package. That means that we have some details in black, like these thingies, like this part in the front bumper. The kidneys are black as well, not the outline, but the inside of the kidney is black. We have 18-inch wheels, bi-color, which are very nice. Shadow line is also part of the sport line package. At the rear, we've got new rear lights, dual exhaust, which is real and actually produces a nice sound, believe it or not. We have a 330i today, so that means that we've got a 2-liter 4-cylinder petrol engine, twin power turbo. Let's take a look at it. There it is. So engine wise, drivetrain wise, there hasn't been that much changed compared to the old outgoing 3 Series. This is the same engine you would find in a previous generation, but they did, you know, adjust the engine a little bit. They did make some small changes to make it run a little bit smoother. So it has 258 horsepower and 400 newton meters. That torque is quite high, actually. It's more than you get from a Golf R these days, so that's not bad. And well, they have done a lot in heat management, ignition, stuff like that. It's just minor changes to make the engine better overall. So with that 258 horsepower, it will do 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 5.8 seconds and on to a top speed of 250 kilometers an hour. And I have to say that I think it's quite a handsome car. I sort of had to get a little bit used to it, but I think in this spec, in this Mediterranean blue with this interior, I'll show you, it's a cognac colored interior with very nice seats, with this aluminium and black. I think this sort of these three colors together look really good together. And we have some wood inlay as well, dark wood. I think this is a very, very nice spec and it's a really nice place to be. So we've got the new iDrive 7 system as well. I've shown you this before, and this sort of layout, this dashboard layout, fits really well in the 3 Series. It's just that I don't really understand why BMW has chosen to just put this in every car now. So the new 8 Series, the new X5, they all have this same sort of layout and this same look. And although I think it's okay for a 3 Series because it feels like more expensive, it's not that good for an X5 or an 8 Series, because it's like, yeah, well, you get the same stuff in a 3 Series. So I'm not sure. I think they should have sort of tried to make it a little bit more expensive and a little bit different in the X5 and the 8 Series, if you ask me. But in the 3 Series, I really like it. So as I said, this exhaust actually produces some sound. So this is in comfort. So nothing special. But if we switch to Sport Plus, there are actually some pops and bangs, but they are not that loud. So while you're driving, it's not that noticeable. It's just sometimes you hear like a little crackle in the distance, which is pretty nice. It does have some fake sound though, and it sort of sounds like a mini John Cooper Works. I'll show you guys right now. We'll just start in Sport Plus. So the new 3 Series. Well, it has always been sort of the go-to car for people who want something sporty and something which handles nice and is still, you know, relatively practical and a nice family car. Well, I'm happy to report it's even better than before. I think that with the last generation, Audi and Mercedes with the A4 and the C-Class sort of caught up to BMW dynamic wise, you know. BMW used to be miles ahead, and with the last generation I think it was a little bit closer, but this new one is so freaking good. This chassis is so good. The suspension, it just all feels so good and so solid. It's really, really incredible. So I'll turn around here. So BMW have worked hard to achieve a 50-50 weight distribution with this car. They have used a lot of aluminium in the body and in the chassis to make it lighter. So on average, these 3 Series are around 50 kilos lighter than the same version of the previous generation. So that's actually quite a lot. And you sort of feel that they have really focused on the driving experience and sort of the driving feel of the car. We have electronic steering, so power steering, but it is really, really good. And the difference between comfort and sport is a lot less big than it used to be. I don't know if you remember, but I always used to select individual mode and put everything in Sport Plus except for the steering. I would keep that in comfort because it was just way too heavy in Sport Plus, but it's much, much, much better now. It's way better judged, and you just sort of feel that you're in control, and you get a lot of feedback through the steering. It just feels really, really good. Okay, so while we're here, we have our Draghi GPS performance box up there. So let's do a 0 to 100 kilometer an hour measurement. If you want one of these GPS performance meters, you can buy it in our store. Click in the top right corner to go to the store. It works super well, super fast, connects in 2 seconds. And then you are ready to go. So as I said, 5.8 seconds is the number given by BMW. So let's see if we can actually get that. So DSC in sport mode, sport for the gearbox, sport plus, foot on the brake, full throttle. There we go. Jerks forward with the shifts and launch control. 5.78, right on the money. So as you could see, this app works really well, works super fast, and it's really, really accurate. So If you're interested, go check it out. Okay, back to the BMW. I have to say that it sort of feels like a miniature version of the G35 series. And I know that has sort of always been the case with the 3 series. But with this one, it feels like the car is even more versatile than before. And that's even without adaptive dampers. We don't have those today. But still, you know, it's really comfortable. And this is just the suspension you have to work with. You know, you can choose anything. You can go to Sport Plus, Comfort and whatever, but it doesn't change the suspension. It only changes the transmission, the steering and the engine and the throttle response. So this setup with this suspension is so impressive. And if we go to Comfort and we just put everything in normal mode, it quiets down, and it is really, really quiet in here. We have 18-inch wheels, but it is still quiet enough, it's comfortable enough, and it's also sporty enough. So that is a very, very well-judged setup, both in, you know, suspension and in everything, basically. So the engine, this version, so right now you can get a 320i, a 330i, a 320d and a 330d, I believe. An M340i is also coming. So that will be the top model for a while, until the new M3 comes somewhere next year, I think, with 374 horsepower, 4.4 seconds to 100. So that M340i will be super, super cool and impressive. And I have been told by a little birdie that a touring version is also coming. So that is going to be epic, and I'm really looking forward to driving that one. So the 330i used to be sort of a no man's land version. You know, we would think, I talked about it with Martijn, and he said, well, just get a 320i or an M340i. Why would you go for this sort of middle of the road version that just doesn't really do anything well enough? But we were surprised. We were very surprised, because this engine feels so torquey, and it doesn't really feel like a 4-cylinder like we're used to nowadays. You know, it's not that asthmatic, it's not out of breath at higher revs. It just feels really solid, like the rest of the car. Especially when you shift like just past 5,000 RPM, it always stays in that power band of that 400 newton meters of torque. So you get that shove, which is really nice. It's actually really impressive, and it's a lot better than before, because we drove the 330 of the previous generation as well, and I remember that I wasn't that impressed with it. So here we are at the Autobahn. Let's see what we can do. That's another fun thing about this car. You can actually use the weight transfer of the car to slide it around a little bit. It's not like a power slide, it's just, you know, playing around a little bit. But it's so well balanced, and the chassis is so well judged, that really easy to do. All right, here we go. So as I said, we have passive dampers. That means that they're not adjustable. So this is supposed to be comfortable and sporty at the same time. It's supposed to be sort of a compromise between the two. And I have to say that if you drive it on a road like we drove it a few minutes ago, it feels nice and light in the nose, and it feels like you can place it anywhere you want. But if you're on the Autobahn at 250 kilometers an hour, it's still comfortable enough, which is really, really an achievement. So that was 260 kilometers an hour in a 330i, and it doesn't blink an eye. It's fine with it. It's actually pretty quick. It's about 0.8 of a second slower from 100 to 200 kilometers an hour than the BMW X5 M50D, the new one. So it is actually pretty quick. Man, it feels like a much larger car. It's so stable. Under braking as well, brakes feel really good, by the way. And you can also upgrade them to the M Sport brakes. You can go for the M Sport version. As I said, we have a Sport line, but you can get an M Sport package, which also gives you 19-inch wheels. You can get an M Sport differential. I mean, you can really spec this car out to drive even better, to handle even better. But I have to say that I'm super impressed with the standard setup of this car. I mean, this already feels so good. And of course, you can go even further with M Performance brakes, M Performance wheels. You can do a lot to your new 3 Series to spec it out and sort of adjust it, configure it even more to your liking. And there are a lot of options. So more than ever, this 3 Series feels like a 5 Series, but also more like a 3 Series than before. I guess because we have a 4-cylinder engine, the nose is pretty light, the balance is really good with that 50-50 weight distribution, the chassis is lighter with that aluminium. So all that adds up to create this really, really good package. As I said, there's also some fake sound coming through the speakers, and it sounds like a mini John Cooper Works. I'm not too impressed with that sound, because if you just go for comfort mode and you do the same, you know, this is fine. It's a 4-cylinder, it sounds okay for a 4-cylinder. Why add that stupid fake stuff? But okay, I guess we have to come to terms with the fact that this is the standard now, and we're not going to be able to change anything about that. So the fact that this car does this so easily almost means that you don't need a 5 Series anymore. Even though the 5 Series feels more like a little 7 Series now, so I guess they have all moved up. But this is so impressive and really, really nice. Cruising along at 260, little bump, no problem, sucks it up. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty crazy actually how easy this is. So the border is inside. I'm going to end this review. Thank you guys very much for watching. You can also check out this video or check out this playlist of POV reviews. We've made a lot of them, so go check it out. And you can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next one. Bye guys.